It says, for there are certain men crept in unawares, who before were ordained to this condemnation. Ungodly men, turning the grace of our God into lasciviousness. It says, you may not be able to reach such people. Others can reach them. Maybe Paul the apostle can talk to them, but you cannot talk to them. Maybe a man like Stephen can talk to them, you cannot talk to them. And maybe somebody like Apollos, who was fervent in the spirit, who knew the scriptures very well, as they tried to turn it upside down, said, no, that's not right, that's the way of salvation. But for the common believer, for the average believer, you may not be able to reach these people. That's why he said, there are people you can match, there are people you can talk to, there are people you can reach. On some, have compassion. And it says, making a difference. What kind of difference? Look at Jude. I'm reading from verse 11. Sin offering is lying by the door. Go take it and make your sacrifice. And the man will not answer. God spoke to him and said, where is Abel your brother? He said, you're asking me about Abel? Am I my brother's keeper? And the people that can reply God like that, he said, they might confuse you if you go to them. Make a difference. Make a difference. There are people that they know nothing, they are ignorant, and when you tell them the gospel, they say, I've been waiting for that. And there are people like the eunuch of Ethiopia that Philip said, do you understand what you read? And the man said, how can I understand except some should guide me? He was not like him. And it was not like Balaam. You know Balaam, he was riding the ass, and then the ass saw the angel and turned this way, and Balaam struck that ass. And don't turn that way, and Balaam struck that ass. And the ass began to talk and said, why are you beating me? What have I done? Don't you see what I see? I'm trying to protect your life. And then Balaam spoke back and said, he was not even surprised. He was not even afraid that an ass was speaking to him in the language of man. He said, if I had a sword, I will kill you. And then the Lord opened his eyes and he saw the angel. And the angel said, why are you beating your ass? Were it not for what the ass had done, I would have killed you and I will spare that ass. And then the man said, an angel was talking to him. Your way is not right. Your way is perverse. Instead of repenting, he said, all right, if you don't want me to go, then I'll go back. He wanted to go. And Jude is saying, you may not be able to talk to people like Balaam. Make a difference between the ordinary sinner and the terrible sinner who is going to argue. Now he says, make a difference. There are people like Korah. And Korah was a person in opposition to Moses. And you know Moses, the one that opened the Red Sea. You know Moses, the one that struck the rock and water came out for millions to drink. You know Moses, the one that lifted up the rod like this, and then victory came to Joshua. He was a man of prayer, a man of power, a man of grace, a man of godliness, a man of the supernatural. In that generation, there was nobody like Moses. And Moses said, Korah, come. He said, no, I'm not coming. You make yourself an Abiram. And you say, can I talk to you? Me? Get out of my sight. Can I look at this? No. Why Jude is average person you see on the street will not be like that. Thank God, the people you confront, well, many of them will not be like that. But make a difference if you're trying to share the gospel and somebody is arguing and he wants to confuse you and he wants to destroy even the faith you have. Then he says, make a difference. Go to the people you can talk to. There's so many people you can talk to, and leave that Cain alone. And leave that Balaam alone. And leave that Korah alone. We're coming back now. I'm coming back to Jude chapter 1. And I'm looking at verse 23. It says, others save with fear. What about that? Others save with fear. What do you mean by this? You see, the angels came to Sodom and they told Lot, they said, tonight the Lord is going to rain fire upon Sodom and Gomorrah. You have anybody there? Very quickly go and tell them. Go and tell them. Judgment is coming and God wants you to be saved. And when he got there, they were arguing with him. They were not listening to him. And then the angel laid hold on their hands. You don't have time to waste. You cannot linger because danger is coming. That's why it says, go to them, but be conscious that judgment is coming. Go to them, be conscious you don't have too much time, and save them with fear. And it says, pulling them out of the fire. Pulling them out of the fire. You know what that means? It's that Jude is already telling us that the fiery judgment is about to strike. The fiery judgment is about to descend. And the people you are talking to, preach to them, pray for them, but do not be partakers with them, because you are pulling them out of the fire. And then it says, hating even the garment spotted by the flesh. Hating even the garment spotted by the flesh. I want you to look at the word of God as it talks about their garments, and their garments are spotted, and their garments are defiling. It's talking about some kinds of people. Let me show you 2 Peter chapter 2. 2 Peter chapter 2. I'm reading here from verse 14. Having eyes full of adultery, that cannot cease from sin, beguiling, deceiving, cajoling, turning aside unstable souls, and hearts they have exercised with covetous practices concerning children. It says when you meet people like that, you want to win them into the light. They want to get you into darkness. You want to win them to righteousness and holiness, and then they are behaving in a particular way. They want to get you into adultery, into fornication, and into defilement, into evil. It says, leave them alone. They are not ready. They are not ready. You are trying to help them and pull them out of the well, out of the dungeon. And they are trying to pull you down into that same well of destruction. That's why it says, yes, evangelize. That's why it says, yes, talk to people. That's why it's saying, go everywhere and knock on their doors and talk to them. But if they want to destroy you and they want to pull you back into evil and into condemnation, it says, make a difference and wait for them until they're ready. I come to point number two now. In point number two, we're talking about the declaration of our preservation in godliness. Come to Jude chapter 1. Are you there? I said, are you there? Are you hearing what I'm saying? To descend, your blessing is about to come. And now it says, now unto him that is able to keep you from falling, he will keep you in Jesus' name, and to protect and to present you faultless before the presence of his glory with exceeding joy. It's talking about our preservation there. There's a few things I want to look at here before I go to the conclusion. Including but him that is able. Think about that. Him that is able. Number two, able to keep you from falling. As you come to the Lord, maybe you think you are not strong. I cannot hold up. I cannot go on resisting all the trials and the temptations. How will I stand? This God we're talking about, as you get saved, and if you are saved already, the Lord will keep you from falling. I thought somebody there will say amen. And then it says, number three, and to present you faultless. And to present you faultless. Then it goes on, before the presence of his glory. And then it tells us, with exceeding joy. Your life will become joyful. Your life will become happy. Give me a good amen. Let's look at them one by one. I'm looking at verse 24. Now unto him that is able. My God is able. I said, my God is able. There's no mountain he cannot move. There's no problem he cannot solve. There's no depravity he cannot remove. There is no sinner he cannot save. And there is no one he cannot satisfy, because our God is, tell me out loud, our God is able. Tonight, he will show that ability. His promise is able to perform. God is able. As he promised to save, is able. As he promised to heal, is able. As he promised to deliver, is able. As he promised to break every yoke in your life, is able. Our look at a fish. It is able to do exceeding abundantly above all that we ask or seek, according to the power that worketh all your problems away. He will do it in Jesus' name. We're looking at Hebrews chapter 2. In Hebrews chapter 2, we're reading from verse 18. Our God is able. Now unto him that is able. In Hebrews chapter 2, verse 18. For in that he himself has suffered being tempted, he is able to succor them, sustain them, support them, hold them up. Is able to succor them that are tempted. When temptation comes, remember, able. Our Redeemer is able. Our Savior is able. Our Deliverer is able. Hebrews chapter 7. I'm reading from verse 25. Hebrews chapter 7. Reading from verse 25. Wherefore he is able also to save them to the uttermost that come unto God by him, seeing he ever liveth to make intercession for them. We're praying for you tonight, and Jesus is praying for you. I said Jesus is praying for you, making intercession for them. Come back to Jude. In Jude, reading that verse 24 again. And now unto him that is able to present, able to keep you from falling. Able to keep you from falling. You know, there are people that think, if I get saved, can I stand? If I get saved, can I be steadfast? If I get saved, can I live the life of righteousness? The Lord will help you. The Lord will keep you. Because he's able to keep you from falling. John chapter 17 verse 12. Whilst I was with them in the world, I kept. If that thou mightest that they might have my joy fulfilled in them. Look at verse 14. It says, I have given them thy word, and the word has hated them, because they are not of the world, even as I'm not of the world. It says you are not of the world. The powers of darkness in the world will not catch you, will not crush you, will not deceive you. I pray not shouldest take them out of the world. Look at this now. The evil, it will keep you from the evil, because we're serving it. God, falling. How long will he keep us? Until he comes. Because come back to Jude chapter 1 verse 24. Now unto him that is able to keep you from falling, and then to present you faultless. That's his goal, that's his aim, that's his desire, and that's what he has power to do, that he will keep you from falling, and then he will present you faultless. Faultless. How does he do that? You need to understand, we get saved, our external sins are forgiven. all the things we have done. When you steal, that's external. Take something from somebody. When you drink, that's external. You take the bottle, external, to your mouth. When you smoke, that's external. External sins given. It's like the branches of a tree. All the branches of the tree, they're cut off the tree. The second step now, take it in the Lord, uproot everything and every branch, the Heavenly Father, roots, that root of sin, that depravity is called sanctification. And it is through that sanctification, a holiness experience, it preserves you faultless until he comes. Look at Ephesians chapter 5. Ephesians chapter 5. I'm reading from verse 25. It says, husbands, love your wives, even as Christ also loved the church, and he gave himself for the church, that he might sanctify it. You see that? He wants to sanctify. That he might sanctify and cleanse it of the washing of water by the word. That he might present, that's the word. That he might present it to himself, a glorious church, not having spot or wrinkle or any such thing, but that it should be holy and without blemish. Holy without fault. Holy without spot. That's what he does. In fact, he tells us in Revelation chapter 14, I'm reading from verse 4 and verse 5. Revelation chapter 14. Reading here from verse 4, that he'll present us without fault. Is able to teach the Jesus or snow tonight in Jesus' name. If you are there, give me a good amen. In Revelation chapter 14, verse 4, it says, these are they which are not defiled with women. And then it says, for they are virgins and they are virtuous. These are they which follow the Lamb whithersoever he goeth. These were redeemed from among men, being the first fruit unto God and to the Lamb. Look at verse 5. And in their mouth was found no guile, no deception, for they are without fault before the throne of God. The Lord saves us by his grace, and the Lord sanctifies us and leads us into godliness. And then he says, he's able to present us faultless when he comes. The Lord will do it for you. And then it says in that Jude chapter 1 verse 24, it says, before the presence of his glory, before the presence of his glory, we're waiting for him, we're expecting him. And when he comes, what glory that will be. And then it says in 2 Timothy chapter 4, 2 Timothy chapter 4. Here I'm reading from verse 4. Paul, he'll do it today. Are you there? I see the Lord did for Paul, he'll do for you today. In 2 Timothy chapter 4 verse 18, it says, and the Lord shall deliver me. Say it for yourself. And the Lord shall deliver me from every evil work. Let me hear you. And will preserve me unto his heavenly kingdom, to whom be glory forever and ever. Amen. And then he tells us, when that happens, there'll be exceedingly great joy. Great joy. Your life will be a joy. Your family will experience that joy. Your victory will bring that joy. It tells us in 1 Peter chapter, partakers of Christ's suffering, when his glory so until that time. You keep serving the Lord until that time, and he will preserve you in godliness until he comes, until the final glory. I come now to point number three. Point number three, we're coming to Jude chapter 1 and in verse 25. Jude chapter 1, and we're reading from verse 25. It says, to the only wise God, our Savior, be glory and majesty, dominion, and everybody say, look at now, the God was served, dominion. All things are possible. That power will be manifested in your life even tonight before you go, in Jesus' name. He has power to save. He has power to heal. He has power to deliver. He has power to set you free. Those blind eyes will get opened. Those lame legs will rise up and walk. The dead will hear. Abilities will be possible in your life in Jesus' name. What kind of God is this that we're serving? Number one, is the only wise God. The only wise God. We're looking at 1 Timothy chapter 1. 1 Timothy chapter 1. I'm reading from verse 17. Always remember that. Whatever happens in your life, take it back to God. Take it back to God. Because the only wise God, he has the wisdom to solve all your problems. He has the wisdom to show you the way. He has the wisdom to unravel and to lose every yoke in your life. That wisdom will operate in your life tonight in Jesus' name. 1 Timothy chapter 1, verse 17. Now, unto the King, eternal, immortal, and an invisible, the only wise God. You see that? Paul is telling us the same thing that Jude has been saying. That whatever problems you have, he has the wisdom to solve it. It's only wise God. Be honor and glory forever and ever. Amen. And now he says, as you look at Jude, and Jude is telling us, number one, to the only wise God. Number two, God our Savior. God our Savior. There's in any other. That salvation is here tonight. It's in the Lord Jesus Christ. God is our Savior. Tonight, save you in Jesus' name. For Timothy chapter 2. In 1 chapter 2, God our Savior, God our Redeemer, God the one that takes us out of the pit of sin, and he brings us to the palace of the King. We're looking at 1 Timothy chapter 2 and verse 3. But this is good and acceptable in the sight of God our Savior. God our Savior, he forgives, he cleanses, he washes our sins away. And he says it is good in his sight, because it's God our Savior who will have all men to be saved. Thank God, salvation is for you tonight. Forgiveness is for you tonight. The mercy of God is for you tonight. The grace of God will flow into your life tonight in Jesus' name. Whosoever shall call on the name of the Lord shall be saved. And he says, so will have all men to be saved and to come to the knowledge of the truth. Then Jude is telling us something. Let's come back now to Jude. And I'm reading here from verse 25. Number one is the only wise God. Number two is the God, our Savior. And then it says, be glory. Is the God of glory. And is the Lord of glory. And because the Lord of glory, glory is coming to your life tonight. Somebody there said, glory is coming to your life tonight. But you know, you must do something. You must do something. You cannot just sit there and cross your leg and fold your hands and just stay there and say, okay, God of glory, where are you? Whatever you want to do, you have something to do. And when you do what he has told you to do, that glory will come into your life. Shame will vanish away. Sorrow will vanish away. I'm waiting for somebody to say amen over there. Calamity will vanish away. And all the suffering will vanish away. Glory is coming to your life tonight in Jesus' name. It's in Psalm 24. Psalm 24, I'm reading from verse 7. Lift up your head, so ye gates. Be ye lift up, ye everlasting doors, that the King of glory may come in. You have to do that. It says, you open the door of your heart, the gates of your life. Swing them wide open. And say, God of glory, King of glory, Lord of glory, the Father of glory, I'm waiting here. And that's why Jesus said, behold, I stand at the door and knock. If anyone hears my voice and he opens the door, I will come into him. Somebody there will open the door to Jesus today. And then he's the King of glory. When he enters in, all shame will go out of your life. He tells us in verse 9, lift up your heads, O ye gates. Even his, he tells us that we should lift up our heads. And he says, O ye gates, even lift them up, ye everlasting doors, that this the King of glory may come in. Who is the King of glory? Is the Lord of hosts. He is the King of glory. He's coming to your life today. Wise God, our Savior, therefore, is the God of all majesty. The God of all majesty. In his majesty, what does he do? In his majesty, what does he want to do in your life, even tonight? I'm reading from Hebrews chapter 1, verse 3. Hebrews chapter 1, verse 3. Who being the brightness of his glory, and the express image of his person, upholding all things by the word of his power, when he had by himself purged our sins, sat down on the right hand of majesty on high. He sat down on the right hand of majesty on high. After he has done what? After he has purged our sin. And tonight, he will purge your sin. I said you'll put your sin. There is no sin so deep. There's no sin so black. There's no sin so terrible that the God of glory cannot take away, because he specializes in pardoning us. He's the God of love, and he purges our sins, and he takes everything away, and then he manifests his majesty and glory. He will do it in your life in Jesus' name. Come back here now to Jude. And I'm reading from chapter 1, verse 25. It says, number one, to the only wise God. Number two, the God, our Savior. Number three, be glory. Number four, and majesty. Number five, and dominion. And dominion. You know what? Jesus Christ, our Lord, has all majesty and glory and dominion. Revelation chapter 1. Verse 5, and from Jesus Christ, who is the faithful witness, and the first begotten of the dead, and the prince of the kings of the earth, unto him that loved us, Jesus loves you. I said, Jesus loves you. God loves me, this I know, for the Bible tells me so. Unto him that loved us and washed us from our sins in his own blood, and has made us kings and priests unto God and to his Father, to him be glory and majesty and dominion forever and ever. Somebody there said forever and ever. He has dominion. Not only that, come back to Jude. I'm looking at it from verse 25. It says in verse 25, Jude, verse 25, number one, to the only wise God. Number two, the God who is our Savior. Number three, be glory. Number four, be majesty. Number five, be dominion. Number six, tell me out loud. Tell me out loud. Power that passes power. Power that will break every yoke. Power that will destroy the works of the devil. Power that will roll all your mountains away. Tonight, there is power. Are you there? I said, are you there? And that power will work in your life in Jesus' name. We're looking at Ephesians chapter 3. Ephesians chapter 3. And I'm reading from verse 20. Now unto him that's able to do exceeding abundantly above all that we ask or think, according to the power that worketh in us. That power will work in your soul, will work in your spirit, will work in your body, will work in your family, will work in your profession, will work in everything surrounding you tonight in Jesus' name. That power will roll your bodies away. That power will cleanse your sins away. That power will heal your sickness tonight. That power will take care of every problem in your life tonight in Jesus' name. That power is now is coming your way. I said it's coming your way. He will save you. He will heal you. He will deliver you. Tonight is the night that power will walk in your life in Jesus' name. I'm coming back to Jude, verse 25. Jude verse 25, here it tells us, to the only wise God, the God who is our Savior, be glory and majesty and dominion and power. Tell me the rest. Both now and ever. Both now, tonight. I said now, tonight. I said now, tonight. You will manifest that power. And tomorrow, and next week, and next month, and for the rest of your life, forever and ever, that thing will continue. And remember now and say that now, ever. Tell me out loud, now and ever. Salvation now and ever. I said redemption now and ever. I said my healing now and forever. Deliverance now and ever. The supply of all your needs now and ever is going to happen. I said it's going to happen. Philippians chapter 4. Philippians chapter 4. I'm reading from verse 19. But my God shall supply all your needs according to his riches in glory by Christ Jesus. I thought somebody there will say amen. I'll give you another chance. But my God shall supply all your need according to his riches in glory by Christ Jesus. Verse 20. Now unto God and our Father be glory forever and ever. Amen. That amen will be fulfilled in your life. The goodness of God will come into your life. Salvation, there'll be an amen to your salvation. Healing, there'll be an amen to your healing. Deliverance, there'll be an amen to your deliverance. Miracles, there'll be an amen to your miracle. Power, there'll be an amen to the power that works in you. It will start right now. Where are you? I say, where are you? Heads bowed and eyes closed. Heads bowed and eyes closed. The goodness of God is about to start in your life. He wants to forgive your sin to start with. He wants to change your life to start with. He wants to bring light to your darkness to start with. Is a God, our Savior. God, our Savior. He'll forgive you. He will cleanse you. He has glory. He has power. He has dominion. He will turn your life around. And as you bow your head and close your eyes, if you want Him to manifest that grace in your life, and to pour in that love in your life, and to save you, and to change your life, to give you forgiveness, redemption, and also to give you their salvation. Wherever you are, you raise up your hand. Raise up your hand. Where are you there? And say, yes, Lord, I'm the candidate for that salvation. I want that forgiveness. I want you to manifest your glory and your grace and take all my shame and take all my punishment and take all my sin. Take everything away. Raise up your hand if you are there. I want that salvation. I want that grace. I want that love of God. I want the glory of God to come into my life. If you are raising up your hand, you will stand up. If you're raising up your hand, you will stand up. Thank you. God bless you. God bless you. You're raising up your hand, you will stand up. You say, Lord, here am I. Here am I. Here am I. I want that salvation. I want that redemption. I want that forgiveness. Stand up wherever you are and say, Lord, I believe. You remember, it says, it's God our Savior. God our Savior. And He wants everyone to be saved. He wants you to be saved. And you, as you are standing up, open your mouth and talk to the Lord. And say, Lord, I need that salvation now. I need that forgiveness now. Change my life. Let your glory come into my life. Let your grace come into my life. Open the door and the King of glory will come in. Open the door and the King of glory will come in. Say, Lord, I know you are knocking at my door. I know you want to forgive me. I know you want to change my life. I know you want to purge me and preserve me unto your heavenly kingdom. I open the door. Come in, Lord Jesus. Come in today. Come in to stay. Tell the Lord, tell the Lord. And tell Him, I'll not go back into darkness anymore. I'll not go back into evil anymore. I'll not go back into those dirty things anymore. I give my heart to Christ. He is my Savior. He is my Lord. And I know you will preserve me until the final glory. As we're standing up there, raise up your hand. I want to pray with you. Yes, God bless you. Raise up that hand. You're standing up. Raise up that hand. I want to pray with you. Father, in the name of Jesus, I thank you for our new brothers and sisters. I thank you, Lord, because you have said, whosoever shall call on the name of the Lord shall be saved. And I bring all these brothers and sisters before. Forgive their sins in Jesus' name. Turn their lives around in Jesus' name. Purge them. And take all the condemnation of their sins away from them in Jesus' name. Bring your majesty in Jesus' name. Let your glory, King of glory, let your glory come to them right now in Jesus' name. Confirm that forgiveness. Confirm that salvation. And let your grace now uphold them to be steadfast, to be spiritual, and to be single-minded, following you until we see you face to face in glory. Thank you, Lord, for the salvation. Thank you for eternal life. And thank you because they have come into the kingdom, they will remain in the kingdom. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Another amen. Keep on standing, brothers and sisters. Those who are standing up, keep on standing. Our counselors will come to you there. And they'll reach out to you. And they'll take, those simple instructions. They'll give you those simple instructions. Comply with that. And when you finish that, in a few minutes, I'll be coming back to pray with you. And the power of God will break every yoke in your life tonight in Jesus' name. We call on our state overseer, Pastor Ogutoyin, to please come and direct us in this counseling session.
I rejoice with you because you have come into the kingdom of God. The paper in your hand, fill it properly. Write your name if you can write. If you cannot write, the counselors will assist you. Give us the correct address. The name you are known. Your GSM number or the description of your house if there is no house number. If you can write, write that by yourself. But if you cannot write, the counselor will assist you. Provide the necessary information on that sheet given to you. It will help us to assist you to grow, to know the Lord the more. We appeal to our counselors to please do that on time and make sure you reach to everyone. Don't go away, because tonight you are going to experience dominion and the power of the Almighty. Don't go with your problem. Don't go with your sickness. Counselor, you have to do that very quickly. Our overseers, group pastors, please help us to supervise as we have demarcated the pavilions into various regions and so on. Let's move in there and get things done on time. Those of you in the pavilion, please let's do that on time. Don't go away. Receive your miracle before you go. Please, converts, don't take the sleep away. But they will give you a package. The pastor's letter written to you that you continue in faith, in fellowship with the children of God. And this coming Sunday, we are going to have believers rally, believers fellowship. The addresses have been written there in the bag and the packet that is given to you. Time is 2 p.m. and 3 p.m. in some regions. So check the one that is appropriate to you and attend so that we can help you. Counselors, you have a very limited time to do that. Don't go away until you get another touch from the Lord. You have got the first touch. The second touch is coming, which is your miracle. You have got the touch of salvation, sanctification. Now, the next touch is touch from above to touch your life, touch your sin, touch your sickness. Unto him that is able, unto him that is able, wait for him. Wait for the power to be demonstrated in your life. Counselors, please do that on time. Our Father and the Lord is waiting for us. If they have not attended to you, can you please raise up your hand and let us know? Those of you at the main bowl, but this football field, can you raise up your hand if you have not been attended to? Okay, you have almost covered that. I can't see most of you at the pavilion, but please do that. If you have not been attended, can you raise up your hand so that the counselor can get to you on time? Don't take the slip. The information on the slip will help us to help you. Christ Jesus. In the language section, please do that. Igede people, Igbo, Yoruba. In those language sections, please do that on time. Behind the pupil chair, those of you who are there, please attend to them. Those are the car park. Please, counselors, get there. Please, can you wave your hand if you have not been attended to? Please round off what you are doing now. But stay there. Don't come, counselors. Remain where you are. After the pastor's miracle prayer, you bring the people that know have testimonies, and so that they can share their testimony with the people of God before they go tonight. Stay where you are. Don't come back. Stay exactly where you are. Those are the pavilion. You will help them because the entrance is by the VIP side. That's where we have the opening into the football field. Please assist those people to come out and give their testimony as soon as they receive their miracle. Please return the slave to the counselor. I said, don't take it away. Return the slave. And counselors, don't forget to collect the slave back from them. Are we through with them? Counselors. Yes. Okay. Thanks for miracle.
Praise the Lord. The power of God is coming upon you. Able. My God is able. You are a God who is able. And tonight, we bring everybody before you. And you show your anointing, and your ability, and your authority, and your power upon everyone in Jesus' name. All that spirit of madness and insanity, I command you, come out in Jesus' name. Deaf and dumb, Lord, I pray, those deaf ears right now, open in Jesus' name. Dumb tongues, speak out in Jesus' name. All the hindrances to your speech, they're taken away in Jesus' name. All the impediments to your speech, they're taken away in Jesus' name. I pray for those who are blind. Glaucoma, I command you, come out in Jesus' name. Cataract, I command you, come out in Jesus' name. All the dimness of sight, whatever is covering your eyes like bandage, that bandage of the devil, get out in Jesus' name. Lord, give them their vision. Give them their sight. I pray, Lord, they will see clearly at this time in Jesus' name. I pray for those who have any broken bone there. Lord, touch their bones. Heal them right now in Jesus' name. And those who have one leg shorter than the other, that short leg, I command you, go out in Jesus' name. One hand withered or both hands withered, I pray that life will come to those arms and those hands in Jesus' name. Those who have stroke, Lord, touch them at the very center, that they will rise up and they will walk normally. Hands will be all right. Feet will be all right. And they'll stand erect without any support in Jesus' name. I pray, Lord, for those who are paralyzed or lame in any way, Whatever is the cause of that lameness or paralysis, take it away in Jesus' name. Let your power come into them. Let your anointing break every yoke. Nobody will miss their miracle in Jesus' name. To the left, perform your miracle upon everyone in Jesus' name. God of all power, manifest your power. God of all glory, manifest your glory. God of majesty, dominion, manifest your dominion in Jesus' name. We know that you have done it. There'll be shout of hallelujah. There'll be shout of miracle. There'll be shout of deliverance. There'll be shout of healing. Confirm it in every life. I thank you because I know it is done. In Jesus' name we pray. Praise the Lord, it is done. I said, praise the Lord, it is done. You are healed in Jesus' name. Those blind eyes can now see. Those lame legs can now rise up and walk. You talk to the deaf and the dumb, they will hear, they will speak. You talk to the person you brought in chains because they were mad, they have been released now. Miracle everywhere. You have got it. And you have the shout of joy as you discover your miracle.
It is done. The miracle is there. Check up, check up. Counselors, as is dead. Check up. As soon as you see the miracle done, just come out. Our overseers, group coordinators, our leaders, go into their midst and we come out to help them and interview them. Please bring them out from the pavilion, from the main bowl here, from the right, from the left. Bring them out so that they can testify of the power of God. You are living here as somebody that have dominion tonight. You have got your dominion. Come out. The miracle is there. Don't cover the goodness of the Lord. It's happening there. It's happening right, left, center there. Are you there? Our overseers, please help them as they bring them out. Interview them. Make sure that you properly interview them. Come out, come out, come out and testify. The Lord has done it. The Lord has done it. He has touched you. Check up there. The miracle is there. The miracle is there. Because God has demonstrated his power in your life tonight. Come out and testify. It is done. It is done. It is done. It is evident that tonight God has touched you. Bring them out. Bring the lame that is walking. The one that cannot see, the one that can see, bring them out. Yes, over there, there's a shout of joy. At my right hand there, over there. Yes. Come out and testify. We are waiting for you. Check it up, check it up, check it up. The Lord has done it. God has visited you. Don't hurriedly go home. Come out and testify. Please start to interview them. Bring them out. Bring them out from the pavilion, from the maple, from outside the stadium, everywhere that the miracle has happened. Please bring them out. We are waiting for you. We are waiting for you. People are waiting to hear the goodness of the Lord towards you tonight. It is done. It is done. Our overseers, please start to interview them. Line them up as to confirm the miracle. Yes, over there. Over there on the left hand side, people are jubilating there. I can see somebody walking straight now. There's a shout of joy. Over there, yes. Please, our counselors, interview them. Our leaders, interview them. Bring them out, bring them out, bring them out. The first testifier, please. We are waiting for the first testifier. Interview them, please. Interview them. We are waiting for them. We want to share the joy with them. Don't go home yet. The miracle is there. It's happening there. Come out and testify. We are waiting to listen to your testimony. I can see somebody there walking. Yes. Come out and testify. The Lord has touched you. The Lord has touched you. Waiting for you, waiting for you. Please interview them. We are waiting for the moderator, please, to come up and prepare himself. We want to take the first testimony. Please electrocute, can you, Pastor Eshaw? We are waiting for you. Bring them out. Don't go home without testifying of the miracle of God that has wrought in your life tonight. Come out, come out, come out and testify. Spectacular testimony, spectacular miracles has happened there tonight. The God of miracle, God of power has touched you. Don't forget the Believers Rally coming up this coming Sunday. As the address has been put into your Believers package that is given to you, the first testifier. Please bring out the yes. Spectacular testimonies. Bring them out so that they can testify. Okay. You can go ahead, please. Give her the mic.
Olúkọ Ọlọ́run.
Another testifier, please. We are waiting for you. Another testifier. Spectacular miracles. Spectacular miracles. It has happened there. Check up before you go. Check out there, the Lord has touched you.
Oh God. Praise the Lord. Amen. Show me ti mo ni le mi o le lo mo because crutches on ti the help of any crutch.
Praise the Lord.
He was using two crutches or under his two arms. But tonight he dropped the crutches and he started walking for the first time. We praise the name of God. Praise the Lord.
It is your another testimony. We are waiting for you. The of God is still there walking. Check up.
Penny or Lauren, Nio Luda Lofemba, and Motini accident. Since then, I'm unable to walk without a stick. So, Logi Money Ruko Jason,
if you can do the DJ, can to like bad, hello, mean a system, if you system, be a settlement. Eh?
Praise the Lord! The woman has stiff neck as a result of some sickness, a kind of illness. But right now, after the prayer of the man of God, you can see her, she can move the neck. And according to her, she was not even able to eat properly. Now, she can eat, she can feel no pain in the neck, and we praise the name of the Lord for that. Praise the Lord!
The next
another testifier, please.
Shake up. The power of God is still working. It's at work. We are waiting for you to testify.
to the goodness of the Lord.
Mama Wenu Ade Ile Logun from Fraudan. In the name of the Lord, because general pains all over the body, the Lord has removed. And according to her, she was having difficulty in walking. The eye was dim, but now the eye can see clearly. As you can see, she walked up to this place by herself without any aid, without any support. Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah. We are waiting for you, the next testifier.
My name is Mary Oleede. I'm from Oshodohe. I bless God when I heard the announcement that our daddy in the Lord is coming to Oshodo. I was so happy because it's been long I've been under his ministration. So I told my neighbors and I came. For the past 2 days, I've been having severe pain on my right knee. I couldn't walk. I couldn't do anything. I was just on bed. Even to go to the toilet, I would need support of people around me. I came here limping with the support of my husband. But I thank God you can see me. I can run. I can jump. How glory to God. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Do it for you.
Won dupe lowo Olorun wipe siwaju akoko yi won ni awon isoro kan ninu ago ara papa bi won ba fe lo to tabi yagbe oko won lo ma n ti won leyin ti o fowo mu won ti won fi le lo sugbon nisin ese yen won tin fi to soke eri bi won ti gbe sugbon mo ri pe ise yanu te gba lale ju be lo baba soro nipa awon eyan kan ti o fe ki agbara isu ko wo ninu aye won ki won domo olorun ka won na je ero orun bawo nipa iyen ki le ri yen si.
I'm saved
now. You are saved by the special grace of God. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. We are going to thank God for what he has done tonight. Shall we rise up and praise the name